them right to counter a bit. Give him what he deserves for attacking me. Okay? The Gidan Bahai, this technique, can be used in multiple ways. It doesn't have to be a block for something. Yeah? It can be an attack. Yeah? Remember last time we did this? Yeah? It's still Gidan Bahai. Yeah? And always remember, the other one has the next turn afterwards, yeah? So, yeah? Okay. Ich, ni, san, chi. And he doesn't like that, so he hits me with his hand. Okay? And we do get him by again. Yeah? You're not doing anything with this arm, you're doing something with this arm. So what we want to achieve here is and you see here is a turn in our body, yeah? So basically what I do is I move around this incoming arm, yeah? So the arm comes here and I do this. It's a bit unsafe, so I use my hand to support this, yeah? My hand sticks to his arm now. I'm not taking it away, I want to feel what he's doing because this hand takes over. The next Gidan Bahai here. Whoop. Yeah. Once from the other side. Sorry. Yeah. So, each. Yeah. And if you want to give it a nice finish. No. If you want to give it a nice finish. Yeah. You just hold on to this. This doesn't move, but your body does. Okay? Yeah? It's a very, very beautiful way of making someone move. It's always very difficult to make someone else move or be active. The point is, to move yourself is much easier than to move someone else. This is the same here. Moving Mike is very difficult, especially if he resists. Moving myself is very easy, and he just has to follow. So this is one of the principles that we have. We don't try to move someone else, we move ourselves. If I move myself, he has to follow.